Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to set up an in-market audience for your Gmail ads campaign. So let's head over to our ad groups, and just like in the previous video, we are going to copy and paste the ad group. So doesn't matter which one it is, I'm going to select one of them and go to edit, copy, close this, and you can paste. Gonna rename this. In market, go in there. Now you may have noticed that there's only one ad in each of these ad groups. You should have multiple ones, so you can create a variation of the ad and have multiple ads in each ad group to split test them. So there's only one ad, so I can either copy this ad and just change the photo or change the heading or something like that. So I'm going to go into in market and then audiences. I'm going to remove this one. So just make sure that you're in the right ad group when you are removing the targeting. That's all. I don't want to be removing it from the affinity one because that's the previous one. So I want to create an in-market audience in the in-market ad group. So click on the audiences, edit audience, go under affinity, beg your pardon, under intent and live events, then you see in-market audiences, right? And the same you can do over here. You can either search in there or you can go in each category and find your target audience. So I will again type in marketing, and now I've got advertising and marketing, and under that I've got SEO and SEM services, which is quite good for me for promoting AdWords. And what you can also have is you can have multiple targeting options in there as well. So if you wanted to target, let's say, web services as well, so there's no hard and fast rule as to how many you can have. If you were targeting multiple audiences, then I would create another ad group. One would target the SEO and SEM services, and the other one will target the web services. Now, it does require a little bit of extra work, but the way we are setting up our ad groups is just a matter of copying and pasting them, coming in here, deleting the existing one, and then replacing it with a new audience. So it's not a lot of work, but what it will give you is the exact data, whether you are getting better results from this audience or that one. So always try and keep them separate and try different things. So I'm just going to keep one for this one and save. So that's set up in market audience. And I've got my ad in there as well. So that's the third ad group done. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one.